loading up over there, and I scroll back a little bit. Here's, I'm going to play three videos. They're very fast, so I'm going to play them one after the other. These are stuff that we're working on and more. Maybe it's a tester on how we're doing things. And then I'm going to show some images of some things that are coming up.
All right, Lady Ada, what is this?
Hey, it's a STEM Sunday, and today I'm reviving a really old project. This is a rotary encoder to I2C converter using Seesaw. It's a little 50-cent chip that does the rotary encoder measurements and then sends the data over I2C. Got my J-Link here because it's going to be fun to debug this. I've got my Metro wired up to this rotary encoder, and you see here I can turn this, and when I turn this knob, I have this Arduino code that is measuring the rotary position and plotting it out for me. So you can see it's working pretty well. What's nice about this is rotary encoders are really annoying to write firmware for. So having it all over I2C means you can connect multiple rotary encoders and you don't do a lot of timing nonsense. So just testing this out, and it's also got a little button you can press. So this will be in the store soon.
Early data, what is this?
Hey, I am working on more rotary encoders with the Seesaw, the SAMD09 I2C to rotary encoder converter. And I already got the single I2C to rotary converter adapter working, but now I'm like, what if I want four rotary encoders? So we've got like one, two, three, four. And I have NeoPixels, and the NeoPixels like change color based on how I'm rotating it, so I can test all four encoders. The cool thing is the code is actually extensible to like 16 encoders if it wanted to, but I think four is a good number. So over on my computer, I've got this example code that's plotting the rotary encoder reading. So this is how I'm just sort of testing to make sure that I can like twist all of the encoders and the values are changing. So looking good, very twisty.
All right, Lady Ada, what is this?
Well, I'm building another QDPI RP2040 tester. This is the QDPI RP20. It is so cute. It's so small. It's got all these pins. And on the back, got that Raspberry Pi logo. It's an RP2040 with 8 megabytes of flash. It's got a StemEQT connector and two buttons and a NeoPixel. And we have to test each board, make sure it works. So I've got this TNT 3.6, and it's using mass storage over USB to literally like load this as a little disk drive and then drag over the test UF2. So I plug this into USB-C, and then I've got this little cutout here, which, because there's no mounting holes, so you have to line it up perfectly. I press the button, and this runs the test. And then it takes about 2 seconds, and then we know it's working. So if you want a QDPI, sign up! It's part number 4900, easy to remember. We're going to be making more of these, as you see. It's fast, so I'm going to test these and put them in stock today.
All right, Lady, what's this?
It is a long, 75-millimeter long slide potentiometer that will connect over I2C and has some NeoPixels on the bottom.
What's this?
This one is a four arcade button with four LED driver, also over StemEQT.
What's this?
This is the QD2040 Trinky. This is the idea of a plug-in board with an RP2040 that you can then put a StemEQT board on top of and turn it into like a little like DIY Trinky.
Someone called it Linky Trinky, and we might have to use that.
I don't know, Linky Trinky?
Yeah, next one's mine. So each Trinky that we're releasing is going to have its own character. This is the potentiometer Trinky.
Sorry, then no, it's the rotary encoder.
Sorry, rotary encoder. This is the
proximity
Trinky. This is a NeoPixel Trinky. And then we started off with this. This is a keyboard Trinky, but then I was talking to Bruce. I'm like, hey, man, like, you might want to make it look more like keyboard. So now this is...
I like it. Like a cool backpack.
NeoKey Trinky.
NeoKey.
And these will be the ones, the first four that we're doing. And then we'll have some non-forever Trinkies. We might like have to call them like NFTs or something. But just stay tuned for these. These are all the characters that go with it. And that is top secret for the week.